The entrance hall set the mood where everyone had come in. The victim, the murderer, the detective. An idea, clear as a vision, waited for me here.
So, you were the director of this play?
Yeah, that's me. Our performance of the cult was cursed from the pre-show ritual on. The cult is an immersive theatrical experience.
You're gonna have to walk me through what that means.
Immersive theater. A play where the audience can participate, spread across this hotel. The cult is a legend. The only written copy of the manuscript lost, the play is passed on as oral tradition between theater companies. Each company only performs it once. The play was said to have special power. You were like kids playing with a Ouija board. And when you call for the devil, it will come.
The pre-show ritual. That's it. Set it up. Start from the beginning. Story was affecting the scene. Layers upon layers. A play about a murder cult infiltrated by a real murder cult. The ballroom was where the pre-show ritual was held.
might ever want to go on. There's nothing left.
I couldn't get in. I was missing something. The room at the end of the corridor was closed off. It felt significant. Something terrible would happen there. I didn't have the key. I couldn't add a new element from here. I'd have to go to the scene. Changed the details of the world. The troop were busy building their own wicker man, where they themselves would be sacrificed. The prop room had been changed from room 104 to room 225.
brings. A special place, a shifting space, existing in a countless number of parallel realities. Sometimes a quaint small town, sometimes a hulking metropolis. Different every time we set upon the road that leads us there. And yet, like a half-remembered echo of a fading dream, always familiar to us. These are the stories that take place there. Awe-inspiring, macabre, terrifying, heartbreaking, nail-biting, absurd, and thrilling. Sometimes all of these things at once. A haunting new season of mind-bending episodes written by Al Wayne. I am your host, Orland Dwar, and I will see you soon in Night Springs.
Thank you.
was locked from the other side. This is where they gathered before the play. This is where it began.
Set up a play in a hotel. Why this hotel?
Because the rent is cheap? No. The Oceanview was perfect for this. It's said to be haunted. Dark stories about murder, death, suicide. Supposedly, an actual cult once performed an unspeakable ritual to summon something in the ballroom. Did we summon the same thing? Tapped into something horrifying? It seemed like it was part of the play, but it wasn't. Does that sound crazy?
You don't want to ask me about crazy, kid.
A haunted hotel. Yes. That's a trope for a reason.
Thank you. Hey, Tim. New map, huh?
Yep. Look, I've never been to New York, but I can tell you that this ain't it.
I heard you humming again.
Yeah, I can't get this song out of my head. It's a real earworm. I hear it in my dreams.
I know that song you keep humming. It's the theme from Night Springs.
That old sci-fi show?
Sci-fi horror anthology. I used to write for a long time ago.
Look, it sounds a bit nuts, but I think the song is connected to Door. Or, it's my subconscious telling me that this is all pretty out there.
The ballroom would be the stage of a key scene in the play.
Thank you.
singing changed with the story. The cult in the play was called the Cult of the Tree. With their deer masks, they were the backwoods echo of the Cult of the Woods urban horror. I recognize my writer's room on the stage.
What was the nice set you got here? What was the scene in this room?
Well, this is what we call the writer's room. In the play, it's where the devil rewrites reality whilst God is asleep. The devil was our star role. I got a big-time celebrity to play him, and he was method acting the role to perfection. He never broke character, always wore the cult mask. His name was scratched out on the posters.
Mm-hmm. And who was this mystery celebrity? Let me guess, Alan Wake?
I wish I could tell you, but turns out there were masks upon masks. Whoever he really was, shit got weird when he was around. Some of the crew joked that we'd actually hired the devil to play himself.
Mr. Scratch is the devil. He was born to play the role.
I had to agree with Casey on that. Dark, but the story had to be dark. This is not my writing. This is Scratch mocking me.
These are my words! You don't have to.
Thank you.
this nightmare from home. They sink down to the bottom of this ocean. I catch them. Visions, echoes, big fish. Some are actual events. Some are forgotten ideas. No, it's good. No, it will work. They're my inspiration, elements for my story to make it more true. Even the parts that are true. I must change reality to escape. The writing has to be just right. Just right. Or else it'll all just wash away.
This was not the ritual murder site I was looking for. This had just been an appetizer before the main course. plot changes shape the world around me. The devil walked through the hotel, dragging the whole place to hell with him.
Choke on these guys.
There's nothing left. No way now.
I felt the presence of a new idea here.
That's if that's who...
Mr. Scratch, if that's who the actor playing the devil was, had stayed in the hotel. Asking around at reception got me a room number. 666. He had requested that room, specifically. The devil had a sense of humor. Or he really didn't. It was funny either way. According to the director, the actor hadn't mingled with the rest of the cast. He had only come out for the play, and always in character.
Scratch had been there. I could sense his presence lingering in the room. I was about to have another killer idea.
Okay, let's talk about the murder victim. The lady who was killed in the climax of the play.
The leading lady. Oh, it was an honor to get to work with her. A grand dame for sure. She went back a long time. Kept insisting she had seen the long-lost original script of the play. She'd been with this mysterious writer, his muse. That was her role in the play. The muse.
She was staying in room 108, where the murder happened.
The set of the final scene, right. The devil comes, an unstoppable force crashing through the hotel through each scene, executed with devastating mastery, and all leading up to him meeting his muse. It turns out he knew her. He'd only joined the play to get to her.
To murder her.
Like you again.
The dark presence had come for me, drawn to the story I was writing as it grew darker. The muse was the murder victim. The final scene took place in room 108. I needed to find the muse, the murder victim, room 108.
fucking Christians.
I've had enough of that freaking gumshoe dick asking too many freaking Christians. Not letting us proper police take care of it.
This is our chance to make the powers that be happy. We'll be set for life. Part of the inner circle.
Well, amen to that, partner. I like it. And so the fraternity, the club, the word. Our dear friends with many names. The way I see it, it was a lone nut job. A junkie out of his mind on some fancy new designer drug.
Open and shut case. All we gotta do now is dump the evidence from room 108 in the usual place in the alley.
This was the murder site. There was a record at the bottom of the bathtub, beneath the body. Somehow, it was important. Another step. Somehow, I was closer to home. Closer than ever before.
It's you again. The FBI agent. Saga Anderson. I'm closer now. I can feel it. You helped me get closer to escaping.
Wake? Are we still trapped? Yeah, the clicker. We can figure
it out. You know about the clicker. It can help us. I destroyed the dark presence with it last time. You can help. You can find it. You must find it.
I can get it to you. I have to understand. Did you write the story?
Alice is in danger. I have to stop Scratch. I have to find Return. I need to get back to my apartment. I'm writing a story to get through. Initiation. It's the only way.
It's a story.
You can do that. You can
write our name.
It lasted only for a moment, like two planets passing in orbit. Saga Anderson was helping me go deeper, closer to escape. Somehow, I had to trust her. Parliament Tower. I had to get back to my apartment, my study. I had to find the manuscript of Return.
Some say that it moves forever, this road that I lose you on every time. Some say that it moves forever, this road. Some say that it moves forever, this road that I lose you on every time. Some say that it moves forever, this road. It's not meant for me. The meant only for you, I see. Wake up, it's only a dream on a winding road. Now that in my bed, in the dark chamber of my head, I flip you over until you bend this winding road. Don't you ever let me go forever. Play and pretend forever, never, ever, never, won't it ever to end? This message that you send to this winding road.
Parliament Tower was here, again. Zane said the manuscript of return was the key to escaping. I had to get it before Scratch did.
There are no known purpose.
Had I chosen to pursue the cult, or had they chosen me for some unknowable purpose? To be a demon, to sort the clues based on my interpretation, to change that which I observed. It was all a play. Shadows on the wall of a cave, an echo of the true events that happened somewhere else. Was I there to watch the shadows, or was I a shadow too? In a performance set up for someone else.
Scratch was closing in, gaining control. I couldn't let him escape the dark place. I had to keep him from Alice. Alice had turned the bathroom into a dark room. I needed to get inside the manuscript.
For months after Ellen died, I didn't leave the apartment. I was flattened by the confusion, shock, the guilt, fear. I could barely get out of bed. Barry Wheeler started visiting. He even cooked me meals. I couldn't stand the guy when I first met him, but he's a better friend than I gave him credit for. He still checks in, even after he moved out west.
Alice's work had consumed the apartment, her whole life.
One morning, I saw a deer soar past my bedroom window. It was a balloon of some cartoon animal. And I looked out at the street below, and I saw a little girl crying. Like losing that balloon had just ended her whole world. It was the perfect image. The horror of caring. And that's when I got myself out of bed and I picked up my camera. Shadows I photographed and filmed, the more I felt like I was on the verge of a breakthrough. I submerged myself in it. I only went out at night. My search became obsessive, but I still had no idea what I was looking for. Shadows. Fear of the dark is really just fear of what could be, that vast, paralyzing ocean. But photography can freeze reality in a snapshot, put a cage around the infinite and capture it. I need to prove those faces are really there.
manuscript of a novel. Return. A horror story about the dark presence escaping from the dark place, taking over Bright Falls. I couldn't remember writing it. I had not written it. I would never write this. I knew who had. Scratch, a monster with my face. If this story came true, Scratch would get out, people would die. Destroying the manuscript, it wouldn't stop it from happening. I would have to fix it, edit it. I could not change the genre of the story. I'd have to work within the constraints set by Scratch. I needed someone in the story to fight the darkness. Saga Anderson. I kept seeing her in my visions. She was already in Bright Falls, already involved, but she was not in Return. Not yet. I'd write her in, try to stop Scratch within the limits of the horror story. It was almost impossible. It was taking too long. I had not reached the end.
This message that you send to this